everyone, ArnoutWizBiz.com, and we are here with Remote Control Part 6. In fact, it's the continuing story of the last video that I made and in which I already introduced my attempts to make a physical joystick over Bluetooth that mimics the Arduino Blue app that was introduced in the last video. This joystick shield is interesting in a way that it already has connectors on the edges in at the top here for a Nokia LCD display and for a Bluetooth module. So I thought perhaps it's a nice base, a nice hardware base to make a remote control. Unfortunately, the Nokia 5110 display is quite small and it's, when you connect it to the edge connector, quite off-center. So I thought, well, perhaps I have to use the I2C bus and connect something bigger. Although not being fully graphical as a display, it can be easily connected by only two wires through the I2C bus that's already also broken out on the PCB of the joystick shield. Finally, I decided I go for only two lines of character information, because that's more than enough for me for now. Okay, so let's take a quick look at the schematics of all the peripherals and stuff that I've connected to my joystick shield. Of course, this being the joystick shield, as you have recognized it. Well, first of all, a LCD screen, which is nothing more or less than your average LCD screen with 16 characters and two lines, that can be connected through a lot of parallel lines, but can do a lot smarter through I2C converter like this. Then you can connect it over here at the bottom of the joystick shield on the SCL and SDA lines of the I2C bus. By the way, these two lines, the SCL and SDA, are the same as A4 and A5 over here, so you cannot use these two at the same time. The same holds true for A0 and A1, because these are already taken up by the joystick on this shield. So that leaves us here on the bottom with two inputs only. One I use as an output to drive this piezo buzzer, use any small resistor in the line, and this one is used as an input, and I read the state of the Bluetooth module. You don't have to, but it is nice, because then you can show, for instance, on the display in this corner, a small graphic that represents the state of the connection of the Bluetooth. By the way, the behavior of this state line is a little bit different. Sometimes it's just a steady signal, for instance with the HC05, and sometimes it represents the blinking state of the LED on the board, on the module. So, but no problem, you can just mimic this here as a graphic, and you'll know by the front of the display if the connection has been good or not. So this is about it. This line, oh, by the way, I pull it up by 10 kilo ohms to, I pull it down to ground, as you can see. Okay, furthermore, we have our RX and we have RTX. And these are also broken out here on this terminal of the joystick shield. So if we all solder this together and bring those components in one place and connect them all to the joystick shield, you get something like this. A prototype of the thing that you saw in the wiring diagram a moment ago. And over here is the little state line going through one of the analog inputs, and the display is connected over I2C. I also had a small piezo buzzer laying around, so I connected that as well. And well, we can switch it on and see what happens. You might recognize the behavior from one of the other sketches that I already described. And you see a blinking LED on the Bluetooth module that's been represented also by a own divined graphic. I did make my own graphic there. There was no Bluetooth graphic yet. And as you can see, the button states are also on the display, just as it was in my other video. And there you have it, the little readout of buttons and joystick values on the display. By the way, the Bluetooth module in this joystick shield is of course switched to a central role. Please refer to the other video, to part one. And here it is. We need, of course, another one, and that's switched to peripheral mode, or most of the times that's already a factory setting. And I'll give you a sneak preview of what's going on between those two modules. Again, refer to part one of this video series for more details about how to configure those modules and pair them together. And as you can see, both throttle, steering and button states are not only being reflected on the display, but also sent by the central role Bluetooth module to the other one. I've also included a small command interpreter to talk back to the joystick shield, so from the peripheral to the central. And let's type in LCD print. The one is line 2 and the column position 1 is also column 2, starts with 0. Hello. Okay, there it goes. And we can also print something on the first line of the display, which being line 0, column 0. This is line 1. Okay. And there you have it. So also talk back to blink it on line 0. Okay. Talk back from the peripheral to the master, to the central. And as you can see, you can blink those lines individually, clear those lines individually, and you can clear the whole display and can go back to value readout of the joystick values and the button values. You might think, what is the piezo for? Well, you can sound it, for instance, for half a second. There it is. And you can also make the frequency. Oh, if you don't specify an end time, it's going on for ages. So I've implemented no tone to silence it again. All right, next stop for me was the workshop and see what I can do with perspex or plexiglass to make a nice casing for this joystick shield. Of course, you can go as far as your own budget, your interest or your skills reach here. Basically anything goes as long as the display has been attached in any way to the joystick shield. As you can see, I've also included a small on-off button and I have removed some of the unused edge connectors there because everything's been soldered underneath directly and it gives a little bit more room for the buttons in this way. Okay, so let's take a look at the Arduino Uno, which is underneath this motor shield, and its connections to the different LEDs, the servo, the motor and the Bluetooth module. Well, if you take a look at my other video about the PS2 controller, you already see a lot of similarities and we won't go into that. So take a look at that video and you'll know how the motor is connected and the LEDs. And you see it here in this scheme as well. What's new is, of course, the little piezo buzzer, which I use digital in and output 12 for. And I've made a small level shifter to bring the RX level to 3.3 volt because the whole motor shield and Arduino are 5 volt. And you can simply do that by taking two resistors and shift the level of input here. The output level of the module is already 3.3 or 5 volt. I'm not very sure, but you don't need a level shifter there. And you just connect it to the other line of the hardware serial. As you can see, I'm not using the software serial solution here. And there is a reason for that. The reason is that this servo, servo 2, is, as you can read here, connected to pin 9. So there are almost no free 4 pins in a row to connect our module. But there is another reason. Once you use software serial to connect to your Bluetooth module, you'll get heavy interference on your servo motors. And that is because the software serial uses a timer to communicate with the TX and the RX. And the same timer is used for the servos, so you'll get a lot of jitter and movement on your servos, and you'll miss transmissions here because they're sharing the same timer. How to solve this problem? Well, you can use, as we already saw, the hardware serial, of course, but there is a problem with that. During development, you have to unplug these two lines before you upload your sketch, otherwise it will interfere with your USB. Well, that's about it. One thing to tell about the encoder motor over here. It has an tacho or an encoder line with pulses, and they are fed into the digital input too. Remember to use a pull-up in your software sketch there. You need to pull up this to 5 volts to read the encoder pulses. Okay, so that's where we calculate our speed and our distance from. Alright, so here you have it, our little Bluetooth remote controlled car with a motor shield on which you'll find a piezo buzzer. And in the middle here, our Bluetooth module, not using software serial because it interferes too much with the servo motor on servo output 2. So I'm using the hardware serial instead here on line 0 and 1, and I've made a small connector so I can unplug it each time a new software sketch is to be uploaded to the Arduino. It's steering, it's reading its buttons, and it's also reading pulses from the encoder motor. And by that we can calculate the speed and distance. You'll find more details in the sketch that can be downloaded from the website. You'll find the link in the comments with this video. So for now, I guess mission completed by controlling this little car over Bluetooth with these Bluetooth modules. And building the command interpreter for the vehicle was quite easy because I committed to the ArduinoBlue software library there. On the joysticks side of it all, I tried to be 100% compatible with that ArduinoBlue software library, which of course means that the Bluetooth joystick shield is completely interchangeable with the original ArduinoBlue app on your smartphone or tablet, which actually means, as you can imagine, that it is really your choice which one to connect to and control your vehicle with. For instance, with the original ArduinoBlue app, like this, or with your joystick shields over Bluetooth. So I really hope you liked this video and my journey into the world of Bluetooth. Leave your comments or your thumbs up, and I'll hope to see you soon with my next project. Happy hacking!